In this video, we'll show you how to train an autoencoder in KNIME. An autoencoder is a feedforward neural network that compresses the input data onto a bottleneck hidden layer and reproduces it on the output layer. Autoencoders can be used, for example, for dimensionality reduction, noise removal, and anomaly detection. We'll show how to train an autoencoder to detect fraud in credit card transactions, which is an anomaly detection application. In this workflow, we access the data with certain numeric features describing the transactions. In addition, the class column shows whether each transaction was actually fraudulent or not. Since the classes are highly imbalanced, we approach the fraudulent transactions as anomalies rather than class instances, and use this class information only later to evaluate the performance of the autoencoder. Let's first build the autoencoder. In the smallest possible format, an autoencoder has one hidden layer. Therefore, we need at least the Keras network input node for the input layer, the Keras dense layer node for the hidden layer, and the Keras dense layer node for the output layer. Since the goal of the autoencoder is to reproduce the input data, the input and output layers have the same size as the number of input features. In each dense layer, we set the activation function to sigmoid. Besides, we set the number of units in the hidden layer to 8. This means, with 30 input features, the compression rate of this autoencoder is 30 over 8, which equals to 3.75. Next, we pre-process the input data. We perform the partitioning into training, validation, and test sets as follows. First, we exclude all the fraudulent transactions from the training and validation data so that the autoencoder only learns to reproduce the legitimate transactions. All fraudulent transactions will be used in the test set for evaluation. Next, we extract 2/3 of the legitimate transactions for training and concatenate the remaining transactions with the fraudulent transactions in the test data. Finally, we extract 10% of the training data for validation. After that, we min-max normalize the features to the 0-1 range. Next, we move on to network training. We train the autoencoder until it learns to reproduce the input data with sufficient accuracy. In the configuration of the learner node, we select the input and target columns and their conversion. The input and target columns are the same by definition. Besides, we select mean squared error, MSE, as a loss function. Finally, we select the error optimizer with default parameters. After the network is trained, we apply it to the test data with the Keras network executor node. We configure the input and output settings, execute the node, and open its output. This node produces the reconstructed features. The key for recognizing the fraudulent transactions is defining how much they differ from the original features. This difference is called reconstruction error, and we calculate it as the mean squared error with the mass formula node. If we then sort the test data by the reconstruction errors in a descending order, we can see that those at the top of the table are mostly fraudulent transactions. This means the fraudulent transactions produce larger reconstruction errors. Therefore, we can use the rule engine node to generate the predictions of fraud based on a threshold. If the reconstruction error exceeds a predefined threshold, we set the transaction to fraudulent and otherwise to legitimate. However, which threshold should we use? Here inside this component, we execute a parameter optimization loop that finds out the best threshold value with the maximum overall accuracy, plus an additional constraint, that sensitivity and specificity deviate at most 10% from each other to account for the class imbalance. After that, we use this threshold in the rule engine node. Finally, we compare the actual and predicted classes with the scorer node. We see that about 90% of the fraudulent transactions were detected correctly as defined by the sensitivity measure. In addition, 86% of the predicted fraudulent transactions were actually fraudulent, as reported by the specificity measure. As a next step, we could try to reach a better performance by adding layers to the autoencoder. Let's check an example. Here, we've built the same workflow, but with a more complicated network structure. It has 5 hidden layers with 40, 20, 8, 20, and 40 units. The other steps stay the same. In this video, we showed how to build and train an autoencoder in KNIME. Furthermore, we showed how to evaluate and optimize the autoencoder's performance based on the reconstruction errors.